So what we're going to do is we're going to add a strip, and then I'm going to show you the different options for it. So to get to the strips, you want to go to this little plus tab, and then you're going to go and find strip. When you're on strip, it automatically gives you a whole bunch of options here. None of them really matter. It doesn't matter which one you choose because you can control and change everything about them. But the one I usually use, and I don't know why they don't put it at the top, but I use the one that's at the very bottom, and it's just a simple image strip. This is kind of your basic strip, the most basic of all. And when you click on that, it's going to drop it onto your page. By default, it has always this little mountain image in it, but we'll change that to your image. Another thing it does is it automatically places it at the bottom of your page. So if you want to get back up to the top where, you know, you'd like it to be. Yeah, you can use the magnifier, but what I like even better is if you click on it, if you have your toolbar open, if you don't have this toolbar open, open it because it's always nice to have. You can reopen it here. You can kind of toggle it on and off. But if you click on this, you have these X and Y coordinates. The Y coordinates are the height on the page. So I can just put in 100 here, and that automatically pulls it all the way up to the top for me. And then I can pull it wherever I want from there. So I use that little Y coordinate a lot to move things up to the top of the page, because whenever you add things, they automatically go to the bottom. So the next step is let's get the image that we want in here, because we don't want that mountain. So we're going to pull up this hand, and now it's in here. The way I have this hand sized, it needs to be a little bit taller for it to kind of work well. So you'll notice that since this strip was small, it was cropping it a little bit. I can either make a much wider image, or I can make this strip larger. A lot of this, what you want to accomplish, is done by trial and error to kind of figure out how it's going to work best and creating the image and the size of it that's going to work best for what you're looking to do. So now the next step is now that we have this strip in here, we can also edit the get background beyond just choosing an image. So if I click again on change strip background, it shows me what image I've already selected. This settings is what you want to click on. And when you click on this, it gives you, and make sure whenever you're in Wix, a lot of these little toolbars or boxes, they have more stuff down below. So scroll to see everything. So you'll have these options like scale to fill or original size and tile. Tile will repeat things depending on their size. I usually almost always use scale to fill because it, and then I size my image accordingly. Basically, I make an image that works well in this size. You can also adjust whether it is kind of at the top or bottom or if it's centered within the pane. The reason it does this is because these strips, depending on the size of your screen, they're going to adjust the width. And so as the width adjusts, the image size also adjusts a little bit to fill the screen. So you never have 100% full control over exactly what size it is unless you use that original size, but that can be kind of problematic depending on the screen. So I like to leave it at full size or leave it fill the thing and then kind of figure out a good happy spot that it works well, and I preview it and play around with it and see if it's doing what I want it to do. The next step is you want to go back into these settings and you want to look at these different options. There's different scroll effects. Right now we have it on just none, and what none does is that when I scroll, it scrolls with the page. The next, thing you want to do, just to show you these different scroll effects, there's also parallax. And so what parallax does is see how it kind of moves subtly within the pane. This doesn't work as well in a strip because see how it's that strip is now cutting it off when it moves. So this wouldn't work well for that particular application. The next one is reveal. This kind of like will reveal it, and it kind of stays static, but then other things will float over top of it. Again, that's not what we want in this case. I'm just showing you some different options. There's also zoom in and fade in. I don't really rarely use those, but the way they work is it kind of gets bigger as you scroll down. So they're kind of neat for photographic or background elements. But anyway, what we want to probably use is maybe just the none. And then what we want to do is, and I think that you might even want to have this as your page background, because then what these could do is these could be moved up and you can now use this to, well, you could even put this over it. I think what we want to do is keep this as a page background, because then you move the humanity down and then the hand is going to subtly move behind it. But if you want the hand to eventually scroll, that's kind of a little bit trickier. You know, we'll have to play around with how it works. That's not working very good either. I think we should, let's go back. I'm going to get rid of this page, this strip background, because so that's an option. And we can always go back to it if we feel like that's what we need. But I'm going to actually make the page background again, the hand, and then we're going to choose the settings on this and leave it at parallax and kind of see how that looks. And let's move this down below. And now let's preview it. So now when this moves, the hand is moving subtly there. Now, if you want the hand to go away completely, another option, and the way I would probably handle it, is I would create a strip. And what I do is I actually create these images for this specific thing. I'm going to upload some into your library so you have some. So if I click here on image, I'm going to upload. I have what I call them, they're black blends, basically. So it'll fade out the hand, basically. Let's go to Wix. So I have a top and bottom, like different black blends. And what we can do is put these into a strip and then fade the graphic over top of it. And we have to change the strip background to be no color, or image opacity, no color behind it. And then I also need to flip it. I should have uploaded a different one. But you can see how, like, I can now make this thing, and I'm going to use this little Y coordinates again to get this up at the top, but I can make it so if I had this reversed, what would happen is that as I scroll down, it would go to black, and then I could put a black bar above it, or we could just have a black bar. There's a couple different options, but what I'm showing you is, like, basically this background, we can play around with it, and then we can cover it up when you want it to disappear. Does that make sense? I'm gonna get this a little smaller. Yeah, let me open up one of those. Like this one? Oops. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's edit this one and look and see how they did that. You might want to just use this as a starting point, but what it is probably... I think what it is... Reveal. Okay. So what it is they've created, okay, so they've created this image. This is one image, sans this, the thing. Yeah. And they made two images exactly in Photoshop. And then what they did is the second image has this thing. That's pretty ingenious, actually. So all it is what happens is when this image starts to go over it, because this one, the way they have this strip background is set to also reveal. So I think the way it works is when you rolling it up, all it is that picture is revealing. And so it, because there's only that part of it that's changed, that's what they've done. So if you want to do that with the hand, we probably have to create two versions of the image. One, I mean, I don't know exactly how you want to, how do you want the hand to? Mm-hmm. Yeah. 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 And you want that to be done via scrolling? When a user scrolls, or could you just fade it in without the user having to scroll?